बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम डियर स्टूडेंट, इन टूडेज लेक्चर आई विल गिव यू द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द पाउडर माइक्रोस्कोपी ऑफ द क्रूड रॉड. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस द कंटेंट व्हिच विल बी कवर्ड इज द इंट्रोडक्शन, ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन टू द माइक्रोस्कोपिक इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ द ड्रग, देन पाउडर माइक्रोस्कोपी, देन टाइप ऑफ प्लांट टिश्यूज प्रेजेंट इन क्रूड ड्रग्स, देन वी विल गिव यू अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द कंपाउंड माइक्रोस्कोप, then reagents used in powder microscopy, and in last procedure of the powder microscopy. This will all be the general introduction. I will not provide you the monographs of the individual crude drug today, rather this is the first lecture, so we will discuss in detail all the parameters. Then inshallah in future I will give you the special monograph of the crude drugs separately. So first of all, what is microscopic evaluation of the crude drug? As you all know, you have done in detail the organoleptic microscope, the organoleptic evaluation of the drug, in which you know it is based on the morphological and sensory characters of the drug. But for the further assurance, microscopic evaluation is used by examining the histological features, because each organized drug has a specific cellular component or element which vary from one crude drug to another. Say for example, you have a powder sample of Nux Vomica, then how could you identify it? Because it will contain certain specific cellular features like glandular trichomes. So when you observed it under the microscope, you can see that the sample belongs to the Nux Vomica. Using the microscope to determine the identity of herbal medicine, namely the microscopic authentication, refers to observing cell structures and internal features by performing their either histology or section cutting by transverse section TS or longitudinal section LS or powder microscopy. In our lab of the this semester, we will cover the powder microscopy of the sample. We will not study the histology or section cutting, but we will focus on the powder microscopy. Now, what is powder microscopy of the crude drug? As you can see it, we have available different kind of powder in our labs. This is the powder of cinnamon, xylinicum or darchini, cinnamon, and this is the powder of Eugenia cryofolia or clove or long. You can see it, both of the powders. So by looking at the powder, what can we examine? That only a few organoleptic characters, like color. What is it color? What is its taste by, you know, taste it, then odor. Therefore, it should be examined using microscope. Only three of the organoleptic character can be seen: the color, the taste, and the odor. Now, the microscopic examination of powder drug depend on the presence or absence of certain cell or tissue element, such as stone cells, fibers, starch grains, oil droplets, calcium oxalate crystal, alluron grains, scleroid, and different kind of cell that are specific for each and every crude drug. So with the help of that, we can identify the powder. Now this is some picture taken from the literature indicating the presence of different kind of cells, that is, you know, four types of cells. The first one is cork cell. A is cork, B is liquefied xylem vessels. You can see it, this is xylem vessel. This C is also the xylem fiber, and the D is the parenchyma cells. And here also different kind of cells are present, which you can observe under the microscope. So these cells are specific for each and every drug. We have monographs available in the Atlas of Microscopy, in which different kind of cell organelles are there, their names are written, and what you do, you make the slide and match it with that, and you can identify your drug. So before proceeding it, first of all we should cover some theoretical aspect like types of tissue system in plant or crude drug, so that you can you may be able to identify the a specific type of cell. So there are three type of tissue system: dermal tissues, ground tissues, and vascular tissues. Now, what is dermal tissue? Dermal tissues are the tissues which cover the external part of the herbaceous plant, external part, you know. So, dermal tissue may be of two types, epidermis and periderm. What is epidermis? You know it before in your intermediate that these are the outermost layer of the primary plant body which covers the root, stem, leaf, floral part, fruit and seeds, like all anatomical part. They are one layer thick with cuticle. They are covered with the cuticle and they are composed of mostly of unspecialized cell like parenchyma, sclerenchyma, and they include the trichome, stromata, etc. So you can say this is epidermis and different kinds of epidermal trichome or hairs. These all are the epidermis cell. Now periderm, what is periderm? The periderm are the outermost layer of stem and root. If the outer layer of the stem and roots are known as periderm, they are also known as bark. They are multi-layered structures. They include cork cells, which are non-living cells that cover the outer side of the stem and root. The periderm protect the plant from injuries, pathogens, and also from excessive water loss. So the epidermis and the periderm are the type of the dermal tissue that are the outermost layer of a plant cell. The second system of the tissues is the ground tissues. The ground tissues, they synthesize the organic compound and support the plant by storing the produced product like primary metabolite and secondary metabolite. They are composed of parenchyma and cholenchyma and sclerenchyma. Three types of cells are included in the ground tissue: parenchyma, cholenchyma and sclerenchyma. The first one is the parenchyma. They are the germinal cells of the plant which are circular in shape and have very thin wall. They have very large vacuoles and are frequently found in root, stem, leaf and fruits. Parenchyma cells help in synthesizing and storage of synthesized food product. Parenchyma cells also control plant metabolism, like photosynthesis, respiration, protein synthesis, etc. They also play a vital role in wound healing and regeneration of plant because they are rapidly dividing cells. You can see a different kind of parenchyma. These are the parenchyma tissues. The storage parenchyma, they contain different, you know, cell metabolite, primary, secondary metabolite in it, starch, green, you can see it. Then these are the aeronchyma. These are special kind of parenchyma in which space is present among them. Intracellular space, you can see it. Now these are the palisade parenchyma containing the chlorophyll. Remember it. These kind of parenchyma cells are present in leaf. Palisade parenchyma containing the chloroplast. So these are involved in the photosynthesis. Now the second type of the ground tissue is the cholenchyma. Cholenchyma are the specialized parenchyma tissues which are found in all green parts. Cholenchyma cells are elongated with unevenly thickened wall. The walls are even thickened as compared to the parenchyma. Cholenchyma cells control the function of young plant. A cholenchyma cell provides support to the plant. Then last ground tissue is the sclerenchyma. They are the rigid non-living cells. These are the very old cells. They become non-living and rigid. They have thick lignified secondary walls and lack protoplastic maturity. They provide strength. A sclerenchyma cell also provide a support to the plant with the help of hardening agent present in their cells. The sclerenchyma are of two types, scleroids. They are short, irregular in shape and have thick lignified secondary wall and fibers. They are long, cylinder and are arranged in thread. Two types of sclerenchyma cell, scleroid and fibers are there, which you will frequently seen in the powder microscopy of the crude drug. This is the basically assembly, pictorial representation of the three basic types of plant tissue. The first one is parenchyma tissue, okay. The second is the cholenchyma, and the third one is the sclerenchyma, the ground tissues, okay. How many types of tissue system you have studied up till now? The first one is the dermal tissues containing the epidermis and the periderm. The second is the ground tissue in which you have studied parenchyma, collenchyma, and scleroderma. The third and the last system which we will study is the vascular tissues. Basically, you have all you have read this all in your intermediate. Here, I am just revising it so that you may able to recognize the special kind of tissue in the crudra. Now, what is vascular tissue? These are the specialized cells with transport of water, hormones, and minerals throughout the blood. They contain transfer cell, fiber in addition to xylem, phloem, parenchyma, cambium, and the conducting cells. They are located in the veins of the nerve. Now, xylem, these are the dead with the hollow cells which consist of only one cell. They play a vital role in transporting water and dissolved nutrient from root to all part of the plant. Xylem is also called water conducting cells. You can see kind of xylem, tracheid, vessel, xylem parenchyma, xylem fiber, you know, different kind of xylem cells. Then phloem, phloem are the live cells which lack nucleus and other organelles. They transport dissolved organic food material or sugars from the leaf to all parts of the plant. Phloem is also called a sugar conducting cell. These are various kind of phloem, vascular bundle, radially. These are basically different arrangement when which will be better understandable when you will perform the histology. But in this labs, you will cover the powder microscopy. This is xylem vessel. This is phloem vessel. Xylem vessel, you can see the arrow. The water and the nutrient are going toward the upward from the root, while in the phloem, both of the two-way flow. Now, this is basically the summary of all three kind of the tissue system: dermal tissue system, ground tissue system, and vascular tissue system. Dermal tissue system composed of epidermis and periderm, and its function is protection and prevention of water loss. While ground tissue consists of parenchyma, collenchyma, scleroderma, its function is photosynthesis, food storage, regeneration, support, protection. Then vascular tissue system contains the vascular bundle, xylem and phloem, transport of water and minerals, and transport of food. Got it? Now, this was all the introduction about the powder microscopy and the type of the plant tissues present in the crudra. Now, we will introduce brief and I will give the brief introduction of the compound microscope, which you will use in your lab. A high power of compound microscope achieve higher level of magnification than a stereo microscope. It is used to view smaller specimens such as cell structure which cannot be seen at lower level of magnification. Now, this is a compound microscope. This is eyepiece, and this is, and these are the objective lenses. Different magnification power: 4x, 10x, 100x. And this is the revolving nose piece. With the help of this, you can rotate the objective lens of your required magnification. Now, with the help of arm, it is incorporated with the stage. The stage have the stage clips with the help of which the slide is fixed within this. And this is diaphragm from which you can control the eye. Now, this is diaphragm, and this is a light source in which you directly control the light if you need the how much the light is needed. Now, the coarse adjustment and fine adjustment powers. Coarse adjustment basically used first to, you know, make the slide visible clear, and then once the slide is fixed, then we will make it more fine with the help of fine adjustment knob. Now, this is the standard operating procedure or recipe for using a compound microscope. We will go through this quickly. Turn the revolving turret so that the lowest power objective lens, that is 4x, is clicked into the position. Then place a microscope slide on the stage and fasten it to the stage clips. Then look at the objective lens and the stage from the side and turn the focus knob so that the stage moves upward. Move it up as far as it will go without letting the objective touch the cover slip. Look through the eyepiece and move the focus knob until the image comes into focus. Are you getting my point? This is the course object adjustment knob. With the help of you will have a look with the help of an eyepiece and make it adjustable so that the slide become visible. Then look through the eyepiece and okay. Now adjust the condenser and light intensity for the greatest amount of light. Then move the microscope slide around until the sample in the center of the field of view. Now use the focus knob to place the sample into the focus and readjust the condenser and light intensity for the clearest image. With low power objective, you might need to reduce the light intensity or shut the condenser. When you have a clear image of your sample with the lowest power objective, you can change to the next objective lens. That is, from 4x you may proceed to the 10x. You might need to readjust the sample into the focus and or readjust the condenser and light intensity. If you cannot focus on your specimen, repeat the step 3 and 5 with the higher power objective lens in place, but do not let the objective lens touch the slide. When finished, lower the stage, click the low power lens into the position and remove the slide. What precautions you have to take? Do not touch the glass part of the lenses with your finger. Use only special lens paper to clean the lens. Always keep your microscope covered when not in use. Then always carry a microscope with both hands. Grasp the arm with one hand and place the other hand under the base for support. Now, what reagent will you use in your lab to prepare the slide, to prepare the powder microscopy? The first one is chloral hydrate, the second one is glycerine, and the third one is iodine. So, for example, you are evaluating or you are conducting the powder microscopy of Nux Vomica, then you have to make 3 slides of each sample. That is, the first slide will make with the chloral hydrate, then the second with the glycerine, and then the third with the iodine. So that if some characters are best visible with the in the chloral hydrate, while some with the glycerine, and some give good result with the iodine. Okay, to perform microscopic evaluation, transfer a small amount of sample on a clean and dry glass slide with the help of a needle. Add a drop of chloral hydrate solution over it with the help of dropper. Make sure that the tip of the dropper does not touch the powder. Make a smear with the help of needle and cover with the cover slip in such a way that no air bubble will be trapped. Quickly pass the slide over the flame in order to fix it. Observe under the microscope and observe the cellular features and note down it. Compare the observation with the given standard monograph. Repeat the procedure using iodine and glycerine solution. Now the question is, what is the standard monograph? So I will let you see that. For example, you are evaluating the sample of cinnamon xylanicum. Then what will you do? You will take the some amount of sample on a clean glass slide, then add a drop of chloral hydrate, then mix it, smear, make a clear smear of it, then quickly pass the slide over the flame, and then observe under the microscope by adjusting the coarse adjustment, fine adjustment. First review, you will observe the slide with 4x, then you will use the 10x objective lens. So after that, you will note down your observation and compare it with the standard monograph, which I will discuss you in detail one by one in our upcoming lectures. Here, for example, I will, you may see it, the monograph of the cinnamon xylanicum or darchini. So you can see it, you have to remember it, that what are the diagnostic features, that abundant scleroid, then abundant fibers, then starch granules, oil cells, parenchymas and medullary rays of phloem, cork cell. Okay, these are the diagnostic features then in the monograph you have this pictorial view in which you can see it. What this is a sample taken from your previous AD student manual. What they have done, the different kinds of cell organelles are provided. I asked them to cover it, to color it, so that they can easily identify the sample. That is, the first one has given a number 1, the one which is in green color. You can see it. What is this? Its description is given below. This is fiber. So green color is matching with it. The second one, number 2, is what? This is the structure is a scleroid. You can see it. Then number 3 is starch granule. You know, starch granule. Then 4th is Cox cell. Here description is written Cox cell. So what you have to do, you have to observe it under the microscope and then see either the structure is present in your slide or not. That, for example, the first one which is green in color is the is representing the fibers. So when the student when make the slide with chloral hydride, they will able to see it, so they make a positive sign here. Then in they make the second slide of cinnamon with the help of glycerin, using glycerin, then they were unable to find the fiber in their slide, so they write a negative sign here. Then the slide of cinnamon was made with iodine, the third slide. In iodine slide also they observe this fiber, so again they mention positive here. Same is repeated for all of the cell organelles, chloral hydride, glycerin, iodine. If you can if you are able to see it under the microscope, then you will write the plus, and if you are not unable, then you will write minus. Okay, so this is how you will carry on your upcoming lectures. So that's all for today. If you have any query, then you may ask it. I will conduct a GMeet also, in which we will discuss in detail whatever the problem you have in your mind, inshallah, in future class. That's all for today. So, thank you.